Good morning, boys and girls. We are going to have our second lecture on chemical kinetics. In fact, I was watching yesterday's video and I was really happy that things went very smoothly. And I'm sure from the views count, I could know that many of you also have watched. And I also tell you, if you are a little deficient in understanding in English, you better watch the video second time. That will give you more confidence. And if you have properly understood, there is no point in wasting time. Now, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please do so. And if you like, when you watch the video by chance, then don't hesitate to put your thumbs up. And today we'll take off the first order reaction, which we had learned, but we didn't write how to derive first order reaction kinetics. First order means rate is equal, it's proportional to the first power of the reactant. Supposing here A is the reactant. In the earlier case, we took R as the reactant. Let's take A as the reactant. And we don't bother about products because we are not finding the rate. We are finding the order. To determine the order, you need to have the power of the reactant concentration to which rate is proportional to. So we have already defined order. I didn't ask you that in my revision program, but never mind. So A to the power 1. Yes, I'd be tempted to ask one of you how to define what is order of reaction. Anybody who can define without looking to your copy? Yes, Ms. Tripathi. Ms. Tripathi.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Sir, it is the power of the concentration of the reactant or the sum of the powers of the concentrations of reactants which appear in the observed rate equation.
A rate equation. Fantastic. Fantastic. So it is the power, it is not the concentration, it's the power of the concentration or sum of the powers that appear in the rate law. And we are now going to derive the rate law. So rate is nothing but dx by dt. We already know rate means dx by dt. X is the product concentration, which is equal to, or let us write before that, let us write once again rate, R is equal to K into A to the power 1. So K is equal to R by A, and hence the unit of K in the first order reaction is equal to time inverse, because this will cancel out moles per liter, moles per second, and moles per liter per second, moles per liter. So the capital M is cancelled, and we are left with only time inverse. So either it is usually second inverse, you can have a minute inverse, you can have hour inverse, you can have year inverse. So depending on the type of reaction, if it is a radioactive disintegration where you know the rate is very, very slow sometimes, then you can express in year inverse, no harm. That's the first order reaction. Have you written that? Go to the next page, please. Then the we shall, you know, this one. Rate is rate, in place of rate, we write dx by dt. is equal to k, and in place of a we write a0 minus x, where x is the product concentration and a0 is the initial concentration, which is fixed. X is the product concentration, which is variable all the time. Initial concentration is fixed while the product concentration goes on increasing. And this is called the differential, this is called the differential rate law, rate equation. And this has no much utility. We have to integrate it and find the integrated rate equation that will be of immense application in solving problems. Now let us do that. So let us bring a0 minus x to the left side denominator and multiply dt on the other side. And let us integrate both the sides. Integrating both the sides, we will have and as I have told you, some of you might not be knowing about integration in your mathematics classes, but just make sure that integration 1 by x dx is equal to ln x, is equal to ln x. Ln means log to the base e, e. So that we are applying here, but since it is a minus sign is there, so it will be minus 1 by, minus ln, I'm sorry, minus ln a0 minus x. This entire is a0 minus x. Is equal to, k is a constant to be removed from the integration sign. So k comes out and integration dt is simply t. And while you do so, you get an integration constant. And you have to find out the integration constant by stipulating the initial conditions. When t is equal to 0, x is equal to 0. At that time, there was no product. At the initial time, there was no product. So t is equal to 0 means x is equal to 0. So when you apply this, t here 0 and x here 0, then we get c0 is equal to minus ln a0. I'm going to the next phase whenever you allow me to do so. So applying t is equal to 0 and x is equal to 0, we get the value of integration constant c0 equals to minus ln a0. Okay. Then substituting the value of c0, we have minus ln a0 minus x is equal to kt plus c0. Now we know what is c0, minus ln a0. And if you bring ln a0 to the left side, it will be ln a0 minus x is equal to kt, which implies if you bring again kt to the left side and keep k only in the left side, this is ln a0 by a0 minus x 1 by t, or it is 1 by t ln a0 by a t. This is the integrated rate equation. That was the differential, which was of little use. This is the integrated rate equation for the first order kinetics. And to convert ln into log, where we'll be solving problems, it will be 2.303 by t log to the base 10 a0 by a t. Right? Put a box. And we can get in different forms. I'll go to the next page to write down the different forms of first order kinetics. Once again, I am writing k is equal to 1 by t ln a0 by a t. Instead of a0 minus x, I am writing a t. A t is the concentration of the reactant at time t. A0 is the initial concentration. And if it is multiplied, it will be kt. And you know, this is the base is E. Ln means log to the base E. So which implies A0 by AT is equal to E to the power KT. Which implies if you just reverse it, AT by A0 is equal to E to the power minus KT. That means it is 1 by E to the power KT means E to the power minus KT. Which implies AT, that the concentration of reactant at time T is equal to initial concentration into E to the power minus KT. That's the reason why the concentration was changing exponentially, not linearly, because AT is related to time in exponential manner. And this is one. We have several expressions. This is the exponential form. Will I go to the next place? Okay. Another one we can have, say k is equal to, can have 2.303 if you want log to the base 10 by t log r0 by rt. Instead of a0 by at, you can have r0 by rt, where r0 is the initial rate of reaction, rate. You know how to find the rate, the tangent of the slope, slope of the tangent drawn at a particular point, initial rate. And RT is the rate at time T. You can also have another form that is, that we'll be discussing. From there, from exponential form, you can get this same form can be converted to this form, AT is equal to A0 into half to the power T by T.5. Just now, we'll be discussing what is T.5. So T is the time, but T.5, it's also called T half, is called the half-life period. half-life period. T half, and in fact this ratio T by T 0.5 is equal to the number of half-lives, number of half-life periods or half-lives. This ratio in the exponent, in the power of half, is nothing but the number of half-lives. We'll be talking about that very, very soon. As soon as we go to the next phase, we will be discussing what is half-life period. Right. Then let us have a heading, half-life period. General definition applicable for all orders. This notation is T 0.5 or T half. It is the time required for the reactant concentration, reactant concentration to reduce to half of its starting value or initial value. It is the time required. It is the time required, It is the time required for the reactant concentration to reduce to half of its initial value. That means when T is equal to T half at that time, AT is equal to A0 by 2. Right? When time is equal to half time, half life period, then half of the reactant has been converted to product. So the remaining reactant is again half. The product is A0 by 2, as well as the reactant is also A0 by 2. Half gone, half remaining. So if we apply substituting these values in first order kinetics, we have already, we developed the first order kinetics as K is equal to 2.303 by T log A0 by AT. So let us put T 0.5 in place of T and A0 by 2 in place of AT, which implies K is equal to 2.303. In place of T, we write half-life period, T 0.5, into log A0 divided by, in place of AT, we write A0 by 2. So A0 get canceled and 2 rises to the top. And then if you crisscross, then we get T 0.5 is equal to 2.303 into log 2. In fact, it is ln 2, remember, ln 2 by K. K will be coming to the denominator, T 0.5 will be going to the left side. So half-life period of a first order reaction is equal to ln 2 by K. You must remember this because often you get question MCQs. Ln 2 by K. Ln 2 is nothing but 2.303 into log 2, and its value, if we put log 2 is equal to 0.301, its value will be 0.693 by K. So put a box to ready-made knowledge about half-life period related to K. Now, can you tell me the most interesting aspect of the half-life period in a first order reaction? Yes, Mr. Khan, I'm sorry, Sajan Singh, first you answer. Then if you fail.
The half-life period of a first order reaction is independent of initial concentration.
Fantastic. I think Khan Saab, aapka bhi wahi, that you also would have answered the same thing. I'm sure about it. That look, the half-life period of a first order reaction is independent of the initial concentration. There is no concentration term here. But in all other orders, you will find A0 term will be appearing either in the numerator or denominator. What does it mean? It means whatever time will be required for 100 gram of a substance undergoing first order process to become 50 gram, same time will be required to reduce from 50 to 25. Same time will be required to reduce from 25 to 12.5. Same time will be required to reduce from 0.1 to 0.005. So that is the uniqueness of first order process. Let us now write down that since T.5 is equal to 0.693 by K, the half-life period, let us write down, that is most important, is independent of initial concentration of the reactant. That means 100 to 50 is, say, T.5 is equal to 20 minutes. For example, this is for as an example, 50 gram to 25 gram, same 20 minutes, 25 gram to 12.5 gram or molarity, whatever, the same time will be required. Even 0.05 to 0.025, the same 20 minutes will be required. So it is independent of the starting value. Instead of telling initial concentration, it should be called the starting value, the starting concentration. Because every time the initial concentration is moving forward, so it is better to call starting concentration. It is independent of initial concentration. That is most official for writing. But for you, I'm just adding a term, starting concentration. But in the exam, you write initial concentration. Now let us draw a graph. If you allow me to go to the next page, we will draw a graph. Then same concentration of reactant versus time. And the graph, since it is exponential like this, it will theoretically never ever meet the x-axis, but practically it will be very, very close to x-axis after a certain half-life periods. We shall try to know, supposing we start 100%, only reactant was there at the initial time. Now, in one half-life period, say 20 minutes, whatever is the, so 50 gone, 50 remaining. This is gone, this is remaining. From the origin, it is remaining, that is 80. And from the top, it is X, it is gone. So the time needed is one half-life period. Just try to remember me. Remind me when I tabulate it. So after one half-life period, 50% goes and 50% remains. Then 50 is the starting point. Then again, for 50 to become a half of it, that is 25, one more half-life period will be required. One more, that means from the origin, it will be two half-life periods. I hope you understand. For 50 to 25, you need one more half-life period. So from the origin, two half-life periods. Similarly, and that means how many gone and how many left out, can you tell me? Gone is 50 plus 25. 75% of reaction is over. And from the origin, it is remaining. 25% of the reaction is left out. That means every first order reaction is 75% complete in only two half-life periods. Now for the remaining 25%, you will see the number of half-life periods will continue to increase and it becomes a never-ending process. But we shall be fed up after five half-life periods. You will be just calculating. There will be 96 point some 8 to 5 like that percent will be over. Then you will be fed up. I'm going home. 96.8 something is almost 100%. So let me not bother. I will declare that the reaction is complete. But the remaining 3 point some percent will be taking a very, very long time. So many half-life periods. You will calculate now that from 96 point something to 99, you will have 1.6 more half-life periods. And to become 99.9%, you need 10 half-life periods. That means 4 more half-life periods. For an increase in only 0.9%, you need 4 extra half-life periods. And from 99.9 to 99.99, you need, that means for an increase of 0.09%, you have to wait for 3 more half-lives. That will be a tremendous Herculean job to wait for those time. So it is therefore, when you are handling a first order process, usually we recommend to wait for 5 half-life periods. And then you can leave the experiment. It is almost 96% means almost over. Now tell me, to become 12.5, you need another half-life period. This is 3 half-life period. And by that time, what percentage is over? 50 plus 25 plus 12.5. That is 75 plus 12.5. It is 87.5, if I am not wrong. Is it so? 87.5% of reaction is over in 3 half-life periods. And again, half of that to become 6.25 remaining, and total will be 87.5 plus 6.25. It will be 93.75%, if I'm not wrong. For 93.75% complete, we need another half-life, that is 4t.5. And again, so I don't have space to reduce from 6.25 to 3.125. Again, another half-life period will be required, that is 5t.5. So you don't write this, we'll be tabulating this 3.125. Therefore, I was saying in 5 half-life periods, 96.825% of the reaction is over, and the remaining 3.125% will take infinite time to literally be finished. So with this much, let us make a table to show how many half-life periods are required for what percentage of reaction completion. Will I go to the next phase? Sambit, you want to, Ms. Swayam, you want to ask a question? Very good. Yes? Mr. Sarangi, please.
Sir, that is 96.875.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Thank you. Mute yourself. So I have done a mistake, committed a mistake. It is 7. Now see how good Sambit is, like all of you. He detected the mistake. Otherwise, you know, the viewers who will be definitely watching sooner or the later, not only you, but because I'm putting it in public mode, so there will be an error. 5, 7, 8. So 96.875% will be over by 5 half-life periods. So let us make a table. Will I go to the next page, please? Have you drawn this diagram? Okay. Then let us write down number of T0.5s and percentage of reaction complete. Obviously, we are not discussing second order. You know, in our Tuesday program, we'll be discussing second order reaction and then zero order. That will be more and more fascinating when you come to zero order. And pseudo unimolecular, pseudo first order is still much more fascinating. And this one half-life period, you 50% complete. Two half-life periods will be 50 plus 25. I'm just, you know, spreading up. 50 was already over and half of 50 is over. So remaining 25% is left out. And in three half-life periods, so this will be 50 plus 25 and half of 25, 12.5, 87.5. If I am not wrong, please raise your hand if I commit some silly mistake somewhere to correct it. And in four half-life periods, you have 50 plus 25 plus 12.5 plus half of 12.5, that is 6.25, that is 93 point, as we calculated before, that is 93.75. And in five half-life, up to which we went, not beyond that, and half of 6.25 is 3.125. That becomes 96.875, and so on. And for the remaining 3.125% of the reaction, you literally will need infinite time. And we will calculate for 99% completion, what will be the, you know, the number of half-lives required. At this point of time, I would remind you, is it over? At this point of time, I will remind you the equation I gave you, that AT is equal to A0 into half. This is a very handy equation for solving MCQ. T by T.5. That is the power. So directly you can take the log on both the sides. And supposing I will ask you, just here there is a question, you find out, I will take a pause, find out the number of half-lives of half-life periods for a first order reaction to be 9% complete. So here T by T 0.5 is the direct ratio that you need, is the number of half-lives. Right? Yes or no? T is the time and T 0.5 is the half-life. So this ratio T by T 0.5 is directly what you are supposed to find out in this question. Number of half-lives. So you can operate log onto both the sides. And now see, if A0 is 100, then now 1 is left out. You take 100. If the initial concentration was 100, 99% is over. So the remaining 80 is the remaining, is 1%. 1 as 80, 100 as A0, half to the power x, that x we are going to find. Then it is in your domain to find out what is the value of x. So 6.64, Mr. M.A. Khan says, x is equal to number of half-lives 6.64. Is there any different answer? Anyone having a remarkably different answer? I want to know that. Chinmayi? Yes, I have unmuted you. Please quickly unmute yourself and answer.
Sir, 6.66.
Oh, 6.66, 6.64, they are close. Now, any remarkably different answer? Otherwise, you raise down, I mean, lower down your hands. Yes, Pratyasa, did you get some remarkably different, like 6.7, 6 point something? Pratyasa?
Oh, sir, the same answer.
Okay. So that means we will take it that, and you mute yourself. So around 6.7 around, or 6.6 half-lives are required for 9. How did you do that? Some of you might not be knowing how it has happened. It is just take the log. You know, being half to the power x to this side and take 1 by 100 to the other side. Or you can take log. If you operate log on both the sides, it will be minus log x log 2 is equal to minus log 100. So minus minus get cancelled. X is equal to log 10 to the power 2 means 2. 100 is 10 to the power 2. So minus minus get cancelled. Log 10 to the power 2 means 2 by log 2. Log 2 is 0.301. And if you divide, I think you will get 6 point something, 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 6.67, I think 6.67, you just check it. So 6.67 or 6.64, whatever, number of half-lives. That is the number of half-lives. We went up to 6.875. 99 will not be the exact whole number multiples of half-life. Therefore, we got a fractional number of half-lives, doesn't matter. At home, I'm giving you another home task, you write down how many half-lives will be required. This is the home task I am giving for the completion of 99.99% of 99.99%, B 99.99%, and see how it is delayed, because same time is needed. Whatever time was needed from 100 to 50, from 50 to 25, same time will be needed from 0.01 to 0.005. So therefore it is being long delayed. So completion of first order reaction. And I'm telling you the answer will be close to 10. And here the answer will be close to 13. Not exactly 13, exactly 10. So from 99 to 99.9, you need nearly 4 half-lives greater. I mean 3.3 half-lives greater. And 99.9 to 99.99, only 0.09%, you have, 3 more half-lives required, right? Now let us go for the graphs. Before we take on to numericals, we have not yet come to the numericals. Let us come to the graphs. Graphs of first order, for first order. Well, I will be writing the equation. Looking to the equation, you will draw the graph. Number one graph, that will be time is equal to say 2.303, or I could have taken ln k log a0 by a t. And looking to this equation, I will be placing t in the y-axis and entire log a0 by a t in the x-axis. Now correlate this equation with y is equal to mx plus c. The x-coordinate is entirely log a0 by a t, and t is the y-coordinate. So what will be the graph? Who have done drawn the graph? You can raise your hands to make me feel that you are not deficient in rudimentary 2D, coordinate geometry. Y is equal to mx plus c concept is, sometimes the y coordinate is changed to x coordinate and vice versa. Then, the slopes will change and you have to accordingly write down the equation first and then draw the graph. Only two hands raised, Mr. Khan and Mr. Abhilash Naik. Then SS. And then RR. This is a pathetic situation that many of you are lagging behind to find out what could be the nature of graph. See. So we are not going to spend more time. Have a look. This is the x coordinate. This is the y coordinate, and there is no intercept. So it will pass through the origin, and the slope of this straight line passing through origin will be nothing but equal to 2.303 by k, right? And had it been ln, and there would not have been 2.303, then slope would have been 1 by k. In many questions, you get, time versus ln a0 by a t. If it is ln, there is no 2.303. Done, we go to the next graph for the first order kinetics. Because, this is filled with large number of graphs for every order. Rajat, you want to ask a question? Chinmay means over. Okay, let us go to the next graph for the first order process. I will write down, let me say 2.303 by k log a0 by at. I am taking the same equation, but this time I will split the log. This will be log a0 minus 2.303 by k log a t, right? So looking to this equation, you draw the graph of t versus log a t. Only log a t, not the ratio. And after drawing, you raise your hands. If it will be found that your graph is incorrect, then you please cancel that and draw once again. Keep it in a very, disciplined manner. Mr. Mitra has done, Mr. Sarangi, Mr. Khan, SS. AT, you are not, you are so very good, You are not raising your hand. You are still there. 80. Where is 80? Oh, 80 has left. Okay, now have a look to the correlation between this is y, this is this log 80 is x, and since the slope is negative minus m, this is m, the slope minus, so it will be like this. And the slope is minus 2.303 by k, and this intercept, which is not of much use because a0 is known, it is a constant quantity, but still intercept is 2.303 by k into log a0. This is the intercept, and the slope gives you the rate constant k. K is the rate constant. That is the rate per unit concentration of the reactants. It is a constant quantity for any reaction at a given temperature. We will learn much more about K for different orders. Who have done this correctly? Correctly? Good. So many. Including Sushovan and Adyasa Mishra and so many, countless. Okay, then another graph. Let us proceed to another graph. Can you tell me if rate is equal to K into, just we did it before to find the order of reaction, AT to the power 1, and if you take log on both the sides, log R, this is dx by dt, is equal to log k plus log a t. So if we draw log r, already we learned how to determine the order. It was n here, then the slope, the slope was is the order of reaction. But now n is equal to 1, the slope is 1. So what will be the nature of the graph? Log rate versus log AT, if we draw, it will be definitely a straight line with a positive slope, and the slope is equal to 1 because it is a first order reaction. Order is equal to 1, and the intercept is log K. Here the intercept is meaningful, as we can get the value of K from here. The anti-log of the intercept will give you K. Let's go, this is the third one, I think. This is the third slope that we are doing. And let us go to another one. Say, I will, this is T 0.5 is equal to 0.693 by K. So if you draw a graph of T 0.5 versus initial concentration, that is starting concentration. When I say for half-life period, I used to refer as starting concentration. Every passing time, the starting concentrations is getting changed. But half-life period remains the same. Therefore, I'm sure some of you must have done correctly. The graph will be parallel to the concentration axis. However, concentration changes, whether increases or decreases, half-life period. In the reality, it goes on progressively decreasing. We go from right to left, but doesn't matter. The graph will be parallel to the concentration axis. So that is the reality. And now it's time for us to look to these prepared PPTs and then wind up today's class. This far we went yesterday, And from there, I will show you this. We have already done the differential rate law and the unit of K for first order we have done. And we have done the integration. I had done a mistake there. C0 was wrong. I corrected that yesterday. And then the different forms, this form, and this one, you please write down somewhere there. Different forms of first order kinetics. Supposing you were not at the time when the reaction began. You do not know what is A0, doesn't matter. You started from T1, doesn't matter. So the numerator will be AT1, and at time 2, the concentration of the reactant is changed to AT2. So this also will have a very good representation of the first order kinetics. Just you add that. So we'll be doing a lot of Mr. Mitra, you want to ask a question? Yes, Mr. Mitra? No. Have you written this? This one we didn't write. This one. All others we have written. This one. We have done so many graphs, half-life period we have done, and these things we have done and understood, so there is no point in spending time. This we have done already, and this list we have already done, and this handy equation AT is equal to A0 half to the power T by T.5, we have used them, and this we have already done. Yes, Mr. Khan was correct, 6.64 was my answer. Okay, koi baat nahi. Yes, okay. I have done it in an alternative method. Number of half-lives here. Have a look. The alternative method, T is equal to 1 by K ln A0 by AT. So if A0 is 100 and it is 99% complete, the remaining reactant will be 1. So this is nothing. 10 to the power square, it is only 2. So 2 ln 10 is equal to 1. So simply it is 2.303 into 2 by K. So the expression for time, the total time in terms of K is this much. And half-life period, the formula is ln 2 by K. I should not have converted to log. Okay, 2.303 log 2 by K. Yes, 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 I should have, because ultimately log 2. So when you take the ratio, T, the total time, it doesn't carry any log term. Log 10 is equal to 1, gone. And T.5 carries a log term, take the ratio, all cancel, KK cancels, 2.303 cancel. So it is again 2 by log 2, the same answer. You can do it by any method you like. This I have given you. And write down the examples. These are some of the examples of fast order process. Quickly write down the decomposition. Write a triangle mark over each arrow. The decomposition of oxalic acid to carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide water is a fast order reaction. Decomposition of ammonium nitrite is also a fast order process. Decomposition of N2O5, here you see, Ms. Misra, here you see in the third example, the coefficient is 2, but actual order is not 2. I told you there is no fixed correlationship between the stoichiometric coefficient and the order. Order is experimentally determined the way we knew. First, find out the rates at different times from the concentration versus time graph, and then take log R versus log AT, and then take another graph. The slope of that graph will give you the order. So it doesn't similarly. And very surprisingly, SS, you will find in many books, Ms. Misra, in many books, you will find 2 is missing. Only because the author apprehends that student might get confused. If I write 2, he might confuse it to be a second order reaction. So instead, they have done 2NO2 plus half O2. They have not hesitated to have a fractional coefficient, but they have succeeded to put it 1 here. But by that, what does it mean? It means that the stoichiometric coefficient is always equal to the order. No, It doesn't equal to order all the times, and you will know this is not a elementary process. We know the mechanism later. It is a complex reaction containing multiple steps, and the slowest step is the rate determining step, and that involves only one molecule in the reactant side. So it is a first order reaction for that reason. So you cannot know by looking to an equation that it is a one step reaction, that is an elementary reaction, or it is a multi-step reaction or a complex reaction. So we will be doing that later in our program, but now write down the decomposition of hydrogen peroxide. I also written two here deliberately to dispel the notion that the coefficient has nothing to do with order. And all radioactive decay process, alpha, beta, positron, all the decay processes are first order. These are some of the examples. Then we go to the graphs. Have you written that, all these examples? Then we go to the next slide to show you if we have left out something. Have a look. These are the graphs we have done. T versus log A0 by AT. T versus log AT, we have done this. Then rate versus AT, we have done. Dx by dt means rate. We have done this. Dx by dt means rate. And also we have done, T.5 versus the starting concentration. This one we have done before, and we can do now. That log R versus, you were taking the log on either side. Oh, yes, we have done this, not this. You draw this one. Rate versus AT, that also is a straight line, but passing through origin. But log R versus log AT will be having a positive intercept. But rate versus, you draw this diagram, this, as the fifth graph, rate is equal to K into AT to the power 1. And in the y-axis, write rate or dx by dt. Dx by dt is nothing but the expression, the mathematical expression for rate versus AT. Drawn? Okay. Then this question you do before we part today, before we finish today, you do this problem. A certain fast order reaction was found to be 30% complete in 20 minutes. How long it will take to be 70% complete? What is its half-life period? All the fast order integrated law is at your disposal, and you use it to solve this problem. Don't look at me, you solve this problem. Now, certain fast order reaction, have a look, was 30% complete in 20 minutes. That means T is equal to 20 minutes. Let it be minutes. And K is equal to 2.303 by T log A0 by AT. This is the first order kinetics, integrated law. Let us take it in the log to the base 10. So let us find out first the rate constant. It is 2.303, time is 20 minutes, let it be same minutes. Log, if 100 is the initial reactant concentration, 30% gone, that means 70 is remaining, 80 is remaining, 30% is over. So you find out what is the value of K. Anybody who can tell me by calculating log 100 by 70, log 10 by 7, that is 1 minus log 7. So what is this ratio? And ultimately, what is this value? That will be in minute inverse. So finally, tell me what is K. Dibya, you were showing your, handsome face, and now after a long time. So what is the value, Dibya?
Sir, K is equal to 0.0178.
0.0178. Is it okay?
8.
0.0178. Yes, you go to at least three significant digits. So if this is correct for all of you, then once you know the value of K, you just mute yourself, Divya. If once you know the the value of K, then T.5, it has asked, is equal to 0.693 by K. So you can find out what is half-life period. So this is 0.693 by 0.0178. So minute inverse, again inverse, it comes in minute. Can you tell me what is the value? I think it is better that I should calculate it instead of spending time, which is 0.693 divided by 0.0178. It is 38.932 minutes. Around 39 minutes, around, but exactly 38.932 minutes. Okay, am I correct? But it is asking how long it will take to be 70% complete. So again, you have to go for the same equation. Now T will come to the left side. T is equal to 2.303 by K log A0 by AT. The same equation you have to put. Now the K value is known. K is 0.0178 minute inverse. There is no point to change into second, because all inverse, it will be coming to the same minute. If it is hour, it is hour inverse, and then finally coming to hour. Now this is log. If 70% is complete, then what is the remaining percent? It is 30. There remaining was 70. Now it is the opposite. 70% complete, and now remaining is 30%. So when you calculate, you get time as the unknown. Can you tell me what is the time? Yes, SS this time, this Swayam, not SS, Swayam. No, Swayam, you didn't, you lowered your hand. You find out, calculate and tell me what is the time required for completion of 70% of the reaction. Yes, Dibya? Yes. Dibya?
Yes, 67.54
minutes. 67.54
minutes.
Right? So, this finishes our program today, and next time I will be, in the meantime I will give you maybe 5 questions on fast order kinetics, similar type of questions in a roundabout way in before Tuesday. I'll give you to practice, and we finish today's class, and I stop the recording